We're in a group, guys. We're in a big group, and it's fun. Of course, I want to be accepted. Of course, I want to ingratiate myself to the people of Chicago. Hot dog, wind. Pizza, architecture, improv. Come on, everybody. All right. No, I always want to be a part of something big. I never worry about being a fascist because of my poor attitude. I never want the responsibilities inherent in being a part of any said thing. Like, I'm a woman. Right? But am I going to be paid less than Greg? Okay, I no longer identify as female.
I am a little man.
Is that offensive to almost everyone? I am a comedian as far as I'm concerned. But if I have to make a bunch of ladies in Napa Valley laugh at a nonprofit luncheon, who books this shit? I do. You know what, ladies? If you could bring me up on stage as a melanoma survivor with an announcement, I think that'll bring everybody to the right level of expectation. I guess I'm an American. I'm ever gonna have to say it out loud. I was part of a giant group as a child. Christianity, any fans? Right? So fun. Woo! 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 No, I loved it. I loved it. It was like a big show. Show business. Every week. It was my first time seeing stand-up, a white guy having a hot take on a weird story. And, tons of fun. Free food. The chow. Tons of chow. But you know, any major religion, they usually ask you sometime between the ages of 5 and 14. They want you to publicly double down. To say, I'm all in on this extremely complicated set of ideas. I cannot read a bus schedule. But sign me up for the duration. I was trying to memorize the shtick. I believe in the one holy and Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. So spooky. I said to my mother, Mother, I don't believe in any of this shit. Look, I stopped 2 years back when I was 8. I stopped believing in God. I stopped being able to sleep at night. I have not slept in 2 years, and I asked God for help. But there is no God. Why can't I sleep at night? My sister gave me titty twisters. It was the 70s. It was not personal. I somehow got it in my little head. I thought, what if, despite the fact it was done to me, I was a victim. I got it in my head. What if I were a titty twister? What if, despite the fact, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it so badly that I'm sitting on my hands up all night trying to prevent myself from doing such a thing. But what if it's out of my control? What if I'm a breast breaker? What if I'm a honk hoot honker? And what if, and I'm going to get in the weeds here, but what if, Mom, it got even worse. What if I chopped you guys all up into chunks and bits? Had sex with the chunks and bits, put the chunks and bits on a Cobb salad, tossed it, and fed it to the baby Jesus. I'm just spitballing. Don't worry. It's a type of intrusive thoughts, OCD. I will deal with it when I'm 35. Wouldn't it be weird? Wouldn't it be weird if I lied? If I broke one of the only rules we have in this group, and I said I believed in something I did not at all believe in, and we all went out for roast beef sandwiches at Arby's. Honey, would you please just do it? The bishop only comes once a year, And that's when I learned, you guys, it is okay to fudge the truth as long as it's a crowd pleaser. And a crowd pleaser is, of course, what my husband calls my bowel movements. As long as, only if they are, scentless, foot-long fecal ropes. He does not applaud for just anything. Chicago, it has gotta be good shit. You guys know what I'm talking about. This is salad country!